Hello there, I'm Josh Modifier Heaven, and today we are going to review the TWS600 from HiFiMan. This is the true wireless version of the 600 series of HiFiMan. Basically, they are RE-A600, but in the true wireless version. Given the fact that the cable of the RI-600 wasn't the most favored one in the world, a lot of people have been looking for a true wireless from HiFiMan. Also, HiFiMan cables are just usually critiqued a bit by some. I like them, but okay. So basically, this is a true wireless headphone. They quote about 38 and half hours of battery life, which is insanely good. They have Bluetooth 5.0. They also have a fast charging port for the case. The EMS charge inside the case. They have only SBC, they do not have aptX Bluetooth, which is something that will come up in the review. I have left them on before doing the video, and it looks like the left earpiece was already entering pairing mode. Basically, once you take them out of the charging case, this is the charging case basically. Once you take them out of the charging case, then the left earpiece enters pairing mode. You can pair them separately. Each earpiece can activate them independently. And to pair them together, you have to first pair the left earpiece with your device, and the two connect together after they are taken out of the carrying case. Not that complicated of a process, if you ask me. This is the design of the EMS. They look pretty cool, pretty stylish. Hope if my camera can also focus. I think they are pretty cool. I like the design, the aesthetics. Pretty forward and pretty edgy. I like it. Basically, they have those two golden connectors at the bottom. And inside the case, there are also golden connectors. Since some first impressions appeared on HiFi, I can actually comment on those as well. Basically, this is the case, and this is the space inside the case. To charge them, you basically put each earpiece inside the case, moment in which the pairing stops, and they start charging. To know that they started charging, they light up red, and there is also a red light indicator of the battery of the carrying case. So you know when you need to also charge the carrying case. The carrying case relies on the USB Type-C connector standard, which I think is pretty great given that we are in 2019 at this moment, and USB Type-C has been becoming the standard for USB connectors. Basically, those are the EMS. I noticed that some early impressions stated that they do not have enough space inside the case, but actually in my experience they do. I use silicone tips, I do not like foam tips. And with the silicone tips they have just the right amount of space. The HiFiMan case does not have a button, you need to open it by prying it open like this. So it has a little magnet that keeps it closed, but you have to pry it open with your hand. They have a little guide there. I don't know, the connection is quite strong. I mean, they stay connected with your device even if you run, jog and such. They are a true wireless EM. They do a good job at that. I apologize for the lights. They will keep lighting up during this review. Let's just take a look what else is inside the package. So basically, this is the my package. You take the little foam out. You get the warranty card from HiFiMan. You also get an instruction booklet, which is quite long. So, you also get a wide selection of tips. Most of them are pretty good tips. And you also get a USB Type-C charging cable. I do not think this also acts as a data cable. I have not tested that quite yet. And you get a little bag of silica to keep the whole package dry. Please remember, for EMs and earphones in general, it is important to keep your EMs and earphones dry because the drivers inside are affected by humidity. The TWS600 relies on the same topology driver as you can find in HiFiMan's latest and most expensive EMs. It is the same idea of the driver. The sound is actually quite different. So this is how they look. This is their design. I think they are pretty cool. I actually like the design quite a lot. I like the gray color and I like the overall aesthetic. It seems that every single true wireless set comes with those two golden connectors on the bottom, so I suspect that they aren't so easily affected by the wax and such inside the ear. I don't know, I should explain this, but wax also has some acidic properties which could corrode other metals, so it is important that those pins stay pretty clean. Anyways, the sound, I don't think there is anything else to talk about besides the sound. So the battery life is incredible, stability incredible, they are very comfortable. Let me try to show you. This is the left earpiece. I face like this, so I can show you. They sit very well in your ears. Oh, there is no driver flex, but there is a bit of void. So they have a more secure kind of fit than, let's say, the one more true wireless. This is how it looks inside your ear. I hope it is visible. Anyways, do not pull them quickly. They void inside your ear. Basically, if you pull them out quickly, you might risk pulling out your eardrum as well. So do not pull them quickly. Be gentle, pull them slowly. Give your ear time to adjust to the changes of pressure inside. Yeah, they are very comfortable once you wear them. They are very secured inside your ear, so you can run, jog with them. Basically, everything is pretty cool. They are a cool pair of earbuds. $150 is the price range. The sound is quite bright, very neutral in the bass. The sub bass is rolled off. It is a mid-forehand kind of sound. It is brightish, because the mid-range at between 1 kHz and 3 kHz is pretty lifted. And then you get a pretty smooth treble, actually. The texture of the treble is quite smooth. I wasn't bothered by it. It works very well with happy music and with vocal music. For example, I liked it with post-hardcore as well. Bands like Dance Gavin Dance and post-hardcore in general works well. They have a happy tonality to it. It is not a cold tonality. It is a happy, more open one. They have a pretty open sound. The soundstage is not very wide since it is a mid-forehand sound. The soundstage is more focused. You feel engaged with your music. They have very little bass compared to what I or you may be expecting, since this is a $100 true wireless kind of EM. You would expect them to have a lot of bass, which they do not. They are pretty neutral in the bass, and the sub bass kind of rolls off as well a bit. A few decibels of bass and sub bass would be necessary to fully enjoy them. Since they pair with your smartphone, you can very easily equalize them, especially if you use something like the Hibi Music app, which I have been using with them. Basically, I would increase the sub bass, so the first one or two sliders of bass, with about 5, 7, 9 decibels, and then lower the main or the gain, so that you do not enter clipping. After that, they are very enjoyable. I don't think it is a very big deal, to be honest. It is interesting that they have quality and sound quality details and such pretty fit for their price point, for the $150 price range. They're very good, to be honest. I mean, I don't have a lot of complaints. If you like a mid-forehand, more lighter, more happy kind of sound, you will enjoy them. Just do not expect a lot of bass, because they do not have it. They are not a bassy EM at this moment. And also do not expect aptX. They have only SBC as far as Bluetooth connection protocols go. Otherwise, I think they're quite lovely. They have enough space inside the case, as you can see here. I mean, this is what you can see. I have been keeping them inside the case so far. I do not take them out of the case, because as I point out in my one more video as well, this kind of EM, the true wireless kind of stuff, are supposed to stay inside their own case so that you do not lose them and such. And once you have closed the case, you are left with an egg-like shaped case, which is very easy to put in a pocket and such. I think it is a great purchase at $150 if you like a mid-range 4-hertz sound, if you like a more open, more bright kind of sound, a more happy kind of sound, and if you want a true wireless kind of ear. Otherwise, there are other offerings, including from Hyphyman, which have a different tuning, which you may like better, like even the RI-600, which is a different tuning. I like both of them, but for different reasons. Both of them work very well with my music, to be honest. I thank you for watching. I hope you'll consider subscribing to my YouTube channel, watch my other videos and such. I hope you have a lovely weekend there, and I hope to see you soon. Bye-bye!